But among you there are some who do not believe. For Jesus knew from the first who were the ones who did not believe and who was the one that would betray him. And he said, "For this reason I have told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted by the Father." Good morning. Welcome to a short biblical reflection on the concluding passage of the Eucharistic speech of Jesus in the Gospel according to John chapter 6. In the lectionary, the readings is just only the verses 60 up to 69. However, I'm extending it also to the last verses 70 and 71. But I'm also including some preceding verses, because as the reading starts in verse 60, when many of his disciples heard it, they said, "This teaching is difficult, who can accept it?" Such statement, of course, it requires that we should read or reread the preceding verses in order to understand why they made this statement. So this is the reaction of many of his disciples, of many who followed Jesus up to this moment, when they heard the answer given by Jesus to the question of the Jews in verse 52. "How can this man give us this flesh to eat?" Then Jesus explains them in the following words, "Very truly I tell you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you." And then, of course, you could continue the reading. I'm just breaking it here. So the teaching of Jesus about the Eucharist was not only hard to understand by the Jews, his opponents, but even by many of his disciples. And we can think that among those who are now questioning Jesus, for sure there are some who were fed by him when he multiplied the bread and fish, and also they could participate, witness to many other miracles. So now Jesus explains it in the category of faith, in the verse which I already quoted at the beginning. "But among you there are some who do not believe." So some who follow Jesus have faith, and the others who follow Jesus, they do not have faith. So not necessarily we should think when we hear in the Gospel the word "the disciples," but they are all of them who are strongly following in what he does and what he says. Now this comes therefore the question of faith and unbelief. And Jesus explains it also in the category in verse 65. "For this reason I have told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted." But also in the question, in the remark which Jesus made about unbelief, also he states about the one who would betray him. And it is retaken in verse 70, this verse which is left out in the lectionary. Jesus answered them, "Did I not choose you, the 12? Yet one of you is a devil." So even among the 12, those which were strictly selected, we could say, by Jesus from all other disciples, even among those 12, there was somebody, there was Judas Iscariot, who we could question if he really believed or what kind of faith did he have. However, we know that he betrayed him. And the words of Jesus in verse 65, "No one can come to me unless it is granted by the Father," from the perspective of faith, we could analyze briefly in the aspect, how is related seeing to believing? Does seeing lead to faith? And if seeing does not lead to faith, why is it? So let's look firstly at some few statements, words of Jesus in the same Eucharistic speech from the beginning, starting from verses 36 and 37. "But I said to you that you have seen me and yet you do not believe. Everything that comes, that the Father gives me will come to me, and anyone who comes to me, I will never drive away." And then verses 44 and 45, "No one can come to me unless drawn by the Father who sent me, and I will raise that person up on the last day. It is written in the prophets, and they shall all be taught by God. Everyone who has heard and learned from the Father comes to me. So in these quoted words, as well also in our text, Jesus insists on the fact that faith is a gift that we receive from God. As it is quoted here, all shall be taught by God. God inspires us to believe, to come to believe that Jesus is the Son of God. But now comes the question, why there are some who do believe and why there are others who do not believe? And the reason to an answer to this question we can find, for example, in Matthew chapter 13, when Jesus explains why he speaks in the parables. Therefore, I speak to them in parables, because while seeing, they do not see, and while hearing, they do not hear, nor do they understand. And in their case, the prophecy of Isaiah is being fulfilled, which says, you will keep on hearing, but will not understand, and you will keep on seeing, but will not perceive. For the heart of these people has become dull, and with their ears they scarcely hear, and they have closed their eyes, as being see with their eyes, and hear with their ears, and understand with their heart, and return, and I shall heal them. But blessed are your eyes, because they see, and your ears, because they hear. In this answer, Jesus, quoting from Isaiah, talks about the hardening of the hearts of the people. In fact, Ezekiel in chapter 36 describes the renewal of the people in the form of exchanging, replacing the heart of stone with a new heart of flesh. A new heart I will give you, and a new spirit I will put within you, and I will take out of your flesh the heart of stone, and I will give you a heart of flesh, and I will put my spirit within you, and cause you to walk in my statutes, and be careful to observe my ordinances. So from this perspective, we can say that seeing the miracles, hearing the sounds, it is not sufficient. It does not initiate, generate, and increases the faith unless there is an internal disposition. Because if the heart is like that heart of stone, it's incapable, unable to respond. But if it is a living heart, it means a heart, the biblical way of expressing an internal disposition tuned to understanding. If that internal disposition is alive, is fresh, then it can generate, it can open a person to new perspective. Therefore, why some who were fed by Jesus, did they believe? And why some others who were fed by Jesus and even maybe were cured and participate in many other miracles, why did not they did not believe? And the same regards also people at any time. There are people who believe, they do believe, and there are people who do not believe because of that reason. Some have this good internal disposition, inclined to believe, but there are others who are close and unable to believe. They are like a stone. I wish you a nice day, a nice reflection on these readings.